Hey you guys, Blaze here from Blazing Reviews, and today we're going to be checking out John Wick Chapter 4 streaming on Amazon Prime. Now this movie was shot in 4.5K. It's got a 4K DI. The runtime is 169 minutes. It's rated R. The aspect ratio is 239 by 1. It's in HDR and the audio is in Dolby Atmos. For the sound, I'll be using my Sony HT-A9 and the settings are as follows. Cinema mode is on. Immersive AE is automatically on. The rear speakers are set to max and the subwoofer is set to max. Audio DRC is on. Sound mode is on and advanced audio volume is on. To record the sound, I'll be using SAM, a high quality binaural microphone able to capture 360 surround sound. So if you put on a pair of headphones, you'll be able to hear what I'm hearing. So, let's get started. Right at the beginning of the movie, John is training and punching a board. And each punch has deep rumbling bass to it that will shake your entire room. When John is chasing some high table members in the desert on a horse, you can hear the bullets flying behind you to the right side and then to the left. When Kane and Chitty show up to the Osaka Continental Hotel, during the fight scene you can hear arrows being fired to the rear left and to the right of you.
Yeah.
As John and Akira go against soldiers at the high table, you can hear gunfire all around you and bullets ricocheting off the walls behind you to the left and to the right side. When John Wick is fighting the big black thug and then the other thug, you can hear gunshots behind you and glass shattering all around you. Then, when John has a shootout with Kane, you can hear the bullets all around you and ricocheting behind you as glass shatters everywhere. During the sword fight between Kane and Koji, you can hear the water from the waterfall falling into the ponds in the background, and the sound of their swords hitting each other sounds like you are literally there in front of them experiencing this fight firsthand. At the Osaka subway station, the announcements can be heard all around you. Then when John's speaking with Akira in the train as it moves, you can hear the train sounds all around you. It makes it feel like you're really there in the train with them, and it's a very immersive experience.
He was a friend. father is dead because of you. Because of what you did. So either you kill him, or I will.
I understand.
The shootout in Killer's Club has some loud-sounding gunshots, with glass breaking followed by Kane's bomb explosion that has some very deep bass to it.
Now maybe a little bit.
And when John is having a shootout with Chidi, you can hear cars whizzing by all around you.
Now, who's gonna be our big winner?
Now, if you are new to the channel and into home theaters and movies and curious to know if a movie is worth playing on your home theater and which movies sound the best, then go ahead and click on that subscribe button. More movie reviews are coming soon. If you've been a subscriber for a while and enjoy my videos, consider becoming a Patreon supporter and supporting my channel. It helps me out to get more gear and movies to review for all of you out there. The dialogue throughout this movie is nice and clear, especially with the A9's Phantom Center channel. This movie was filmed digitally, so the image quality is extremely 4K perfection. Everything is razor sharp. So sharp, in fact, that you can see all the pores, wrinkles, and other details of each character's faces perfectly. It looked so fantastic on my LG C9 OLED. With HDR, the colors really pop and are very bright. The HDR has a max CLL of 2458 and a max FLL of 636. The opening scene at 2 minutes 22 seconds in of John riding the horse in the desert is a fine example of how great and bright the HDR in this movie truly is. There are plenty of neon lights used throughout this movie and they look fantastic, especially scenes of the Continental Hotel in Osaka. But the best example of HDR in this movie is at 2 hours 8 minutes in, when John uses the Genesis 12 shotgun with incendiary ammunition called Dragon's Breath. Each time he shoots a person, they catch on fire, and the fire is super bright. The guy fully on fire, trilling and running around, looks amazing. However, black details in some scenes looked a little washed out and not as black as they could have been. Then in other scenes, they looked really deep and dark. This could be due to this streaming on Amazon and hopefully doesn't show up when the 4K disc is released. I'm gonna give the audio a blazing score of 9. Throughout this movie, pretty much all shootout scenes have great surround sound effects with bullets flying in every direction. You can hear them ricocheting off of walls and hitting objects and glass shattering all around you. It truly sounds very amazing. I especially like the Osaka subway scene at 55 minutes 11 seconds in, where it makes it sound like you are in the subway with them. It's a very immersive experience. And the opening scene with John punching the board had such deep bass that things in my room started shaking and I could feel it inside my body. I'm gonna give the image quality a 9 also. Like I said earlier, this is 4K perfection and it looks really good. It's definitely demo worthy and a movie you'd want to show off how good your display looks. So there you have it, you guys. Have you watched John Wick Chapter 4 on your Sony HT-A9, A7000, A5000 soundbar, or whichever home theater you may have yet? Are you going to be watching it soon? Let me know what you think about it in the comment section down below. I thought this movie was action-packed and definitely was worth the wait to watch it on my home theater. I'll definitely be watching it again. As always, thanks for watching. More videos will be coming soon.